What's up, guys? Thanks for joining me on another episode of Sam Has a Spending Problem. Today, I have a review of three different filters that are all CPL and ND built into one filter. But unfortunately, only two out of three of these filters are variable ND. The other one is locked in at 1000 ND, and that's the Polar Pro. But we're gonna do the best that we can with these three filters. If you already know how an ND filter or a CPL filter works, then I want you to skip ahead to the time that just popped up on the screen. But for everybody else who's just starting out or is new to camera filters, basically an ND filter is like sunglasses for your lenses. You can buy them in different strengths, which makes your image or your video darker. And they come in different filter thread sizes, which you can find on the side of any of your lenses. It'll be a little number with a little zero after it with a line through it. ND filters are used for a variety of different purposes in videography and photography. One of the more simple things that you might use an ND for is if you wanted to get a deliberate motion blur effect by lowering your shutter speed. Because when you lower your shutter speed, your sensor is going to be absorbing a lot more light, which brightens up the image. So you may use an ND filter to offset that effect. Obviously, while you're filming, you're not going to be changing your shutter speed all that often because it directly correlates to your frame rate. So having an ND available to you gives you more control over the amount of light getting to your sensor while filming. And obviously, you could use your aperture to cut down on light as well, but having an ND filter available to you just gives you another degree of control. As for CPL filters, they're still kind of magic to me. Their main purpose is to cut down on glare on surfaces like cars or water, but it's not always as much of a direct, tangible effect as an ND filter is. Sometimes I find myself spinning my CPL filter and wondering if it's doing anything at all. And another thing that you have to take into account, especially when you're starting out, is that more glass equals a softer image. So if your image is running through an ND filter or a variable ND filter and a CPL filter, that's a lot more glass for that image to get through. But this video isn't CPL filters explained, so if you want more information, let me know down in the comments and I will do a whole video about how CPL filters work. So moving forward, I buy all of my filters in a 67mm thread because that is the step-up range that I have for all of my lenses, and I know that that size is going to be big enough to cover any lenses that I may want in the future as well. I don't know about you guys, but one of the habits that I'm happy that I picked up early is buying all my filter rings and step-up rings in the same size so that I don't have to buy a separate size filter for each of my lenses. Believe me, I'd love to be rich enough to buy a different high-end filter for each size thread that I would need for all my lenses, and a separate high-end filter for each stop of light for all the different situations that I may be shooting in. Now that you've listened to me prattle on about what filters do and how I use them, let's move on to the point of the video, the reviews and test footage. As far as prices are concerned, the K&F Concept comes in at $80, the newer comes in at $53, and the Polar Pro Quartz line comes in at a whopping $160. And I can already hear all the boomer photographers and the kids that don't buy their own gear saying,
"Oh, well, you gotta pay to play, man. You get what you pay for. Buy it nice or buy it twice."
I forgot that all you professionals only use the nicest of the nice top shelf gear that was okayed by Lord McKinnon himself. I'll keep that in mind the next time I'm dogging your mom. The K&F Concept 67mm variable fader ND2 to ND32 ND filter and CPL circular polarizing filter 2-in-1 for camera lens, no X-spot, weather sealed. Again, word limit, please, for the love of God, Amazon. I'll start by saying this. This is the most usable filter on the list, meaning that if all three of these were in my camera bag every day, this is the one that I would pull out more than the other two and use. So the K&F Concept CPL and variable ND filter has an all metal weather sealed body, and it says that they have a new nanotech coating on the glass, which is supposed to make it dirt, water, and oil resistant, as well as being scratch resistant, but I'm not going to test it because I'd like to keep this filter. As for oil and grease, like hand grease resistant, I don't think that it's gonna stop that. I mean, if you get a big ass thumbprint on your filter, you're gonna wipe it down one way or another. I don't see how a coating is gonna stop that from happening. And while we're on the topic, K&F Concepts seems like a nice brand. I mean, they're kind of like a middle-of-the-road budget brand, but they're not quite as crappy as like Newer or Amazon Basics is. So you're not going to get anything mind-blowing or amazing from them, but you're also not going to have to take out a second mortgage on your house to buy one of their filters. K&F Concept seems like one of those brands whose sole purpose in life is to come up with a cool concept and then let Newer or Amazon Basic copy it word for word and then sell it for $15 less.
What were we talking about?
Oh, the review. So the filter. It's a filter. It does variable ND. It does CPO. I mean, it doesn't do either of them amazingly, but it does it to the point where I would use it. I like the idea that I can just throw this filter on my lens and go for a day trip and handle anything that the day is going to throw at me. It's not particularly large or cumbersome, it's not going to get in the way of anything like a gimbal or an Arca Swiss plate, and as far as aesthetics are concerned, it's a filter. It's just a black on black filter with two little posts coming out to handle the ND, and it looks fine. I mean, it's a filter. Adjusting it is a breeze, but it feels solid enough to where it's not going to move out of place like some of the cheaper filters that I own. Another thing that you might take into account is that this filter is made of aluminum as opposed to brass like the higher end filters out there. Basically, the K&F Concept filter on this list is your middle of the road. It's not the crappy one, but it's not the amazing one either. It's going to be a solid addition to your gear. And me personally, I use this thing every single day. It's just too versatile of a tool to not have one on you when you're filming or taking photos. Now, normally at this portion of the review, I would move on to the next one, but because the next one is the Newer filter, we're gonna pause here for a moment. If you've ever used any product by Newer, you know what they're about, but if you're unfamiliar, allow me to explain. What Newer does, much like Amazon Basics, is they take another brand's product and they just copy it, normally with cheaper manufacturing and cheaper materials, and then they undercut their competition by selling basically the same product for a little bit less money. So everybody buys that one instead of the more decent one. The reason I'm using this portion of the review to tell you this as opposed to telling you about how the filter functions and what its quality is like is because you could basically just go back to the beginning when I started talking about the K&F one, substitute the word K&F for Newer, and you'd have the exact same review because this thing is identical to the K&F one. Of course, this begs the question, why would I spend $20 more on the K&F one if you're telling me that the Newer one is identical? Well, it's not identical. I totally lied to you about that part, but I promise I won't do that again. So basically, for the extra $20 that you would spend on the K&F, you're getting some nicer packaging and maybe a slightly sharper image. I want to say that the Newer is a little bit softer around the edges when you use it, but I'm not positive. And I also want to say that the K&F feels like it has slightly nicer glass, but I'm not 100% on that either. It's basically a toss-up between these two. And I know that's not what you guys want to hear in the middle of a review, but they're really hard to tell apart. If you buy both of them, you'll see what I'm talking about. The K&F feels a little bit nicer when you're turning the CPL portion or turning the ND portion. But that may just be because the Newer one is a little bit more broken in because I got it earlier than the K&N one. But for this one, I'm gonna let you guys be the judge. Let me know down in the comments which test footage looks nicer, the Newer or the K&F Concepts. We still have one filter left, which is the Polar Pro Quartz Line ND1000 and CPL filter. When this filter shipped to me, I really wanted to hate it. I even recorded a whole portion of this video where I was hating on it, but I would totally be a hypocrite if I hated this filter. It does its job and it does it well. My issue is that I thought that it was a variable ND filter with a CPL built in, much like the other two, but it's not. It's a non-variable ND1000 filter with a CPL filter built into it, which is admittedly my bad. But anyway, an 1000 stop ND filter is pretty dark. And when I say pretty dark, I mean really dark. Like, you have to be pointing directly at the sun for this thing to pick up any sort of image whatsoever. Unless you're a photographer and you're using it for long exposure, which totally makes sense, and it does that job beautifully. I decided to give this thing a second chance and run down the road and get some long exposure shots, and I love the way they came out. I also really love the way this thing looks and feels. I mean, the adjustment on the CPL portion of this filter is crisp as hell, and it just looks nice on the front of the lens. Maybe this is just me being a camera nerd, but every time I see a Polar Pro filter on the front of a really nice lens, it's just, damn, man, they look nice. It also comes in this really nice metal case with this magnetic backing to it that holds the filter in place and this foam on top that protects the glass. Really nice presentation by Polar Pro in this case. If I ever hit the lottery or make it big or decide to rob a bank finally, I'm definitely going to have the full set of these because they are just so nice. But basically, for video, I can't really use this thing unless I'm filming in super bright situations, unfortunately. It's a very nice filter, but I think it's more of a niche item for long exposure or photos that involve bright lights. It's just not something that I'd see myself using a whole hell of a lot for filming. That being said, I would like to try out one of the variable ND filters that Polar Pro offers because of how nice this one specific filter was. But unfortunately, Polar Pro charges double for their variable ND because Peter McKinnon's name is on it, and I couldn't find a quartz line variable ND anywhere, so yeah, I'm not spending double on something just because his name is on it. Don't get me wrong, I don't mean to sound like a hater. I think Peter McKinnon is amazing at photography and amazing at video. But that being said, he's not double our prices amazing just because his signature is on the side of it. But anyway, that's all I got for this one, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know down in the comments if you have any requests or reviews that you would like me to do. And also, like and subscribe if you found this helpful. Shout out to Sigma America for subscribing off that last video, and I will catch you guys in the next one. Bye!